Are you moving to Luanda, Angola, and you're not sure what to do for fun? Well, I've got you covered. Hi guys, welcome back to another video on Life by Melissa Andrew. I am so excited about today's video. Angola has such a special place in my heart, and I am so excited to share with you all the fun things that you can do when you live or visit Luanda, Angola. Before we get into the video, guys, you know the drill. Go below, hit that red subscribe button, and every week I am back with some new videos about my life living in Angola, Argentina, and just expat life in general. And be sure you're following me on Instagram. I share about my life every day, so if you're curious what I'm up to as I'm repatriated back in Texas, Instagram is where I'm at. All right, guys, let's start indoors. So for those warm summer months or rainy season months when you don't feel like being at the pool, you can go to the movies. And the movies were a really big part of my life living in Luanda. I think when you're in that theater and the lights go down and the movie comes on and you're eating your popcorn, your Coca-Cola, and it was just a really fun experience for an afternoon on the weekend. The movies in Luanda are typically going to be in English and they'll have Portuguese subtitles on the bottom. But if you're going to see a kids movie, so normally kids movies are dubbed in Portuguese. So the big three movie theaters in Luanda, Angola are going to be located at Bella's Shopping, at Xiaomi Shopping, and Shopping Avenida. So we started at Bella's Shopping when we first moved there. It was the only theater at that time. And we enjoyed going there, but then they added Shopping Avenida, and it's a really nice complex, a really great grocery store, Candando, and they have an IMAX movie theater. And it was so nice. It was brand new and the only IMAX theater in all of Angola. So it was definitely a favorite among the expats because you had the stadium seating, the seats were very comfortable, you would select your seats before you went in the theater, and overall it's just a really, really good, fun movie experience. All right, now we're gonna switch gears. We're gonna go outdoors and we're going to go over to Masulu Island. Yes, there is an island just off of Luanda, and it is only about a 10-minute or less boat ride from a terminal area, basically in the middle of Luanda. And when you wanna go to Masulu, you can just go over to that terminal and there are lots of boat taxis, lots of them, waiting for customers, and you just tell them where you wanna go and hop on. They usually have life vests for you, and then they will take you over to Masulu Island where you can enjoy the day. So we were really fortunate that our company had a small piece of land on Masulu Island where we could go and enjoy the day. There were barbecue pits and lawn chairs and that type of thing. And a lot of companies have this as well. So definitely if you're moving over there on an international assignment, check with your company to see if they have some kind of accommodations on Masulu Island. But even if your company doesn't, I would definitely still check out Masulu Island because there's lots of other accommodations. You can easily get an Airbnb or there's small hotel, motel type things where you can stay overnight. Or there's also areas where you can just stay for the day. So definitely check it out. It's a great place to go to the beach and just kind of unwind, and you can see Luanda from afar, and it's really a great day. So speaking of the beach, now we're going to go from Masulu Island over to the Ilia, which is basically right off of downtown Luanda. And it's a small strip of land that kind of sticks out into the Atlantic Ocean. And on one side, there are lots of restaurants. And when it's warm, you can go to one of the restaurants on the Ilia, and many of them have a beach club. So what you can do is, typically you'll order drinks and maybe some lunch, and you'll have access to their beach club, which is essentially lawn chairs and day beds and umbrellas on the beach. So you can either eat in the restaurant, back in the restaurant and have the ocean view, or you can be in the beach club, which is actually on the sand, and you can enjoy your day. You can eat their food, drink their drinks, and enjoy your day at the beach. I spent a few beach days at Kurbe and it was really nice. The sand is really pretty there. What you do have to watch out for though is if you go in the Atlantic Ocean, just be careful because right there the undercurrent is very strong and you just want to be aware of that. But other than that, it's really gorgeous, great food, the best, some of the best in Luanda on the Ilia, and great beaches. So speaking of the Ilia, those same restaurants will sometimes at night turn into a nightclub. And nightclubs are huge in Luanda, just like any other major city in the world. They are all over, but there's definitely some really good ones on the Ilha. So if dancing and drinking the night away is your thing at a nightclub, then definitely check out some on the Ilha. You can go during the day to the beach and maybe go home, take a shower, take a nap, and then come back to the Ilha for some nighttime dancing. I wouldn't say Angola is necessarily known for its shopping, but there's a lot of shopping plazas that you can go to in Luanda. And one of the best ones is in Bella's. It's Bella's Shopping in Talatona, which is in Luanda Sul, kind of a suburb of Luanda. And some others are gonna be Shopping Avenida, Shiami Shopping, and also the Nova Vita Atrium. They all have kind of the same, they usually have a large grocery store and then they have smaller stores that you can shop in. So definitely check those out if you're, you know, wanting a shopping fix and you're wanting to see what they have out there. There's really some good shopping plazas that you can take advantage of and walk around and see what you can find. Okay, now I'm gonna tell you about one of my favorite things in Luanda, or it's just outside of Luanda, and that is Kisama Park. And that is their national park where they have safaris that they offer. And I plan on talking about safaris a little bit more in the future on this channel because Andrew and I went on probably a dozen safaris when we lived in Africa. We absolutely loved them. And I've got lots of tips on what to do on safari and how to plan and how to pack. So I'm definitely gonna be sharing those in the future on this channel. So hit that subscribe button. But if you live in Luanda, Kisama Park is a great place to go for, I would say, the day, and you can do a daytime safari. And when you get there, you can get into one of the vehicles they have there and they take you around the park. And it was so exciting to see the wildebeest and the elephants and the giraffes. It was such a great experience and I would definitely recommend it. Great for kids or just adults. We went with another couple and it was so much fun. So if you're living in Luanda, you do not want to miss Kisama Park. Again, it's just an hour south of Luanda and it's a great place to spend the day looking for animals. All right guys, if you're a golfer and you're moving to Luanda, pack your clubs. I made this mistake. I didn't take my golf clubs with us. I didn't realize there was gonna be golfing there, but yes, there is golfing in Luanda and there is a really beautiful course just outside of Luanda along the Kwanza River, and it's Mengais Golf Course. It's a great place to spend the day. It's out in nature, so it's a really great reprieve if you're getting kind of tired of the city, if it's becoming too much, or you're just tired of being in the city and you want some peace and quiet, then definitely head out there. You have the Kwanza River, there's a polo club next door, so you have horses that kind of roam around a little bit. We've seen some wild pigs when we go, and it's really just a great way to spend the day. So if you're a golfer, A, take your clubs, and B, head out to Mengais Golf Course because it was so nice, so peaceful, full of nature, and it was just a really great reprieve from the city. All right, guys, I've got one more before I tell you about surfing. And that is going to be EcoTour. So EcoTour is a company. I want to give them a shout out because it's a really cool company based in Luanda, Angola, and they offer tours of different areas in Angola. So I would highly recommend them. We took the tour to Kisama Park with them. We had friends that went to different regions of Angola with them, and they've all been highly recommended trips. So definitely check out EcoTour. I will leave the link below in the description box. And I highly recommend if you're living in Luanda to go on a few of their trips. They have everything from 1-day trips to I think 5 to 7-day trips even. So definitely check it out. You can go see different regions of Angola, and it's a really great way to just explore where you're living. So we finally got to surfing in Luanda, and you can't surf in the middle of Luanda, but you can drive about an hour and 15-20 minutes to an area called Cabaleto. And when you get to Cabaleto, you're going to find a very wide and sandy beach that is just perfectly positioned on the Atlantic Ocean, and the waves come crashing in. And so they're really good for surfers. And while you won't have the beach to yourself necessarily, it was fairly empty. In fact, a lot of people would actually camp overnight. We didn't do camping, but a lot of people would go on Saturday and then surf all day long, hang out on the beach and camp overnight and then leave on Sunday. So if you enjoy a beach and you enjoy surfing, then you're definitely gonna wanna pack your surfboard in your shipments if you can. and head over to Caballito as soon as you get to Luanda. All right, guys, that's everything I've got. I hope this video gave you some great information on what you can do in Luanda for fun. As you can see, you will not get bored there. There's so many things to do, everything from indoor activities, movies to shopping to nightclubs. I didn't even talk about all the restaurants there are. There's so many things. And then the outdoor activities too. Obviously you're on the water, so there's lots of beach things. There's golfing, there's pools, which I didn't talk about very much. So don't worry when you move to Luanda, you will not be bored. There's so many things to do. And I will see you guys next week. Bye.